Good evening, everybody. Welcome to our nightly virtual jazz club concert. Thanks so much for joining us once again. This is the start of week number 6 right now. I can't believe it. It's really, really hard to believe this has been going on for 6 weeks already. Or 5 full weeks going on 6. Yeah. For those of you who might be joining us for the very first time tonight, we are Laura Dubin and Antonio Guerrero. Thank you so much for being here. It's truly been a pleasure sharing our music with you every night. We began these concerts on March 17th, and we have not missed one night, nor have we repeated any tunes yet, and we're going to see how long we can go without doing that. So great to have you all here. Please leave us a comment and say hello. If you're here for the first time, please introduce yourself. We're delighted to meet you. And let us know where you're watching from, whether you're here in Rochester or maybe you're in another city, state, country.
Galaxy, dimension,
reality. Do you like how I always look at you now to tell them that?
silly.
We really like outer space. Ideas, yeah. So tonight we'd like to start with a really fun classic tune by the great pianist Fats Waller called Ain't Misbehavin'.
Thank you.
That was a classic jazz standard called Ain't Misbehavin' by one of my personal favorite pianists and composers, Fats Waller. And to me, his piano playing was just so definitive of the time period in which he lived and the time period in which he was most prominently composing music and performing, which is the 1920s and 30s. When I imagine myself like going back in time, that would be cool if that could happen someday. When I imagine myself going back to hear like those, you know, the original kind of stride piano players, Fats Waller's music just immediately comes to mind. And he's just been a big inspiration to me my whole life since I first discovered his music. So we hope you liked that tune. Next, we'd like to play one of our arrangements from West Side Story. And as most of you know, we released an album called Laura Dubin Trio Plays West Side Story last summer, and we premiered all the music at the Rochester Jazz Festival. And this is our arrangement of Something's Coming. Probably a good title for now. We don't really know what's coming, but it's something for sure.
Something good is coming.
Thank you. That was Something's Coming from West Side Story. I think that's a appropriate tune for right now when we don't really know what's going to happen next in this world, but there's definitely something on the horizon.
What was happening in the movie when these pieces?
I was just going to say it was an optimistic song in the movie. Yeah, it's actually in the very beginning of the movie or the musical, the stage version. It's before Tony and Maria actually meet, but he senses something in the air that something is going to happen to him. Exactly. And of course, that something is that later that night he meets Maria. So it was something good. So let's hope that something good is coming our way, because I think the world deserves it. So if you're enjoying our music tonight and you'd like to make a contribution to show your support, you can head on over to lauradubin.com. There's a link right in the video here. You can either wait till we're done with the performance, or you can, you know, click away and then come back, or you can click on the link on another device so that you don't have to leave us right now. But we hope at some point this evening you'll click on that link. It will take you directly to the music and store page of my website. And there are three different things you can do there. The first is that you can download our albums. We've got 7 albums that you can choose from. You can also make a one-time donation. There are several suggested amounts that you can choose from. You can also adjust them if you'd like by changing the quantity. And then the third and final option, if you go all the way to the bottom, you can become a monthly patron of Laura Dubin Jazz. So if you'd like to see us continue doing these videos for as long as possible, that's a great way to show your ongoing support, and you just have to set it up one time and then you don't have to think about it anymore. So you can click whatever amount you'd like to donate once per month from the drop-down menu there. And then when you click on the yellow button that says subscribe, you'll be redirected to a PayPal website. And that's where you can set up your automatic credit card payment. It'll just go through once a month. You can always manage your settings and change it later on if your situation changes and you are no longer able to make the monthly payment. There's no penalty if you do need to cancel at any time. But of course, if you choose that option, we hope you'll continue as long as you can. And the PayPal website is secure. My website is also secure. It stores all your credit card info securely. We don't have any access to that information. However, if you want to make a donation, but you prefer not to do it online, please send me a private message here on Facebook, and we can talk about another method. And if you're not able to make a donation right now, that's totally okay. We're so delighted that you're here listening to our music. And a huge thank you to all our friends who have been supporting us this whole time and sharing our videos. It really means a lot to us, and our audience has really grown considerably in the last few weeks. Thanks to all of you for sharing our videos and promoting us. It's been so great, and we really can't thank you enough.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you all.
Next, we'd like to play kind of a jazz fusion kind of tune?
It's Freddie Hubbard.
Yeah. This is a tune called Red Clay.
And it's the drummer. Well, I'm sorry for saying this, but it's a Lenny White.
Oh, that's awesome.
And I think these...
you don't have to be sorry for saying that.
Yeah, well, this group is very nice.
It's very,
I don't know, smart.
Yeah.
I want to say.
It's more than just like an average rock drum group.
Exactly.
It's got something really
interesting
about it.
He's definitely a jazz drummer playing something kind of...
putting his own Lenny White spin on it.
Yeah. But Lenny White was playing with Chick Corea and The Return to Forever with somebody. That's why sometimes people don't relate it with some other projects, but Freddie Hubbard was
playing with it. And this is the 70s, this tune. So we hope you enjoyed this tune called Red Clay by the great trumpeter Freddie Hubbard.
Thank you.
That was called Red Clay, composed by the trumpeter Freddie Hubbard. And I'm looking at the album cover up here now, and there's Lenny White on the drums, like Antonio mentioned. What a band this is. So Joe Henderson on the saxophone, Herbie Hancock on the piano. He just had his 80th birthday last week. Go Herbie. Ron Carter on the bass, another jazz legend.
It was groovy, baby.
It sure was. Well, I love the title of this next tune. This is called Hot House, and it is a bebop tune composed by the pianist Tad Dameron. And this tune is called a contrafact. And a contrafact is a jazz tune that is based upon the chords of a pre-existing song, and just it's got a different melody. And this is actually a contrafact of Cole Porter's What Is This Thing Called Love? And just as a little side note, I always I love this title, Hot House. Every time we go to Wegmans and I see these tomatoes called Hot House Tomatoes, I get this tune stuck in my head. Apparently that means they're grown in a greenhouse. I actually Googled that last night. I just thought it was a fun name for a tomato, but apparently it means that's how it's grown. I don't think that's what he titled the tune. I don't think Tad Dameron named this tune after a tomato. But anyway, I like the title and the tune itself. Thank you. was called Hot House, composed by the pianist Tad Dameron and based on Cole Porter's What Is This Thing Called Love? What do you think it is? I think we know what it is. Well, we've got just a couple more tunes for you. And for those of you who might be joining us for the first time, please leave a comment and say hello, because after we finish the music, we like to stick around and chat with all of you for a few minutes. We like to read through the comments and say hello to everybody who's listening out there. And also, if you're here for the first time, please know that we're doing these concerts every night at 8:30 p.m. And if you like my Facebook page, if you haven't liked it already, please go ahead and give it a like, because then you'll be notified every time we do these live videos, anytime we post any kind of music-related content, or anytime we have news to share. And speaking of which, we'd like to invite all of you, if you're an early bird, to tune in to Good Day Rochester tomorrow morning at 8:40 a.m. It's going to be on Fox Rochester. Good Day Rochester is actually on two different channels. They have an earlier show and a slightly later one, and we're going to be on the slightly later one, which is on Fox Rochester. That's at 8:40 a.m. We'll be doing a live interview over Skype, and they'll be showing a promotional video that we've put together of our concerts here. And for those of you who heard us announce a few days ago, this is actually the second time we've been on the news this week, so we're so excited. When I announced a few nights ago, and I apologize for any confusion that there was, the other day we did a little interview on News 10 NBC, and I thought that it was going to be a live interview. So the night before, when we were doing the concert, I invited all of you to tune in the next morning. But it turned out they were actually recording the interview, and then they were actually showing it later that same day. But I promise that this time it's actually going to be at the time that I just said. Exactly. It's really going to be live, and it's going to be at 8:40 a.m. So we'd love for you to tune in if you're awake. If you're not up that early, I think it'll be on the internet later on that day, and we're definitely going to record it.
Oh, yeah, yeah, we will.
Somehow it will definitely be shared online. So we're really looking forward to the opportunity. We're so delighted that these news stations have been taking note of our concerts.
Yeah.
And it's just been really great, having these really take off. We're so thankful and grateful for all the community support we've been getting in Rochester and beyond. So let's continue with the music. Next, we'd like to play a piece by Antonio Carlos Jobim, the great Brazilian composer who wrote so many beautiful tunes that have all become jazz classics. And this one is really fun. It's called One Note Samba. Although I would have to disagree with the title, because it's definitely got more than one note.
So many.
The A section. So when I say the A section, most jazz tunes are in like AABA form. So the A section does just have one note in the melody. Well, I guess two notes.
Yeah.
But the middle section is extremely challenging as far as the notes go, because it actually the melody in the middle part of the piece is pretty much a major scale in two of the most difficult keys. So I'm happy to rise to the challenge, but it's funny that it's called One Note Samba, and then it's in reality it's got that that middle section.
Should be called
One Note Samba in the A part.
Yeah, exactly.
Plus thousand.
Thousand note samba in the bridge.
Yes. And in the solo.
Yeah, exactly. So we hope you enjoyed this tune, One Note Samba by Antonio Carlos Jobim. Not to be confused with Antonio Humberto Guerrero Garcia, who's right here. They've got very similar names. And actually, if Alejandro is watching right now, Alejandro Jr., something funny happened when you sent me a Facebook friend request the other day. I saw it. I got a request that said, his full name is Alejandro Guerrero. Alejandro Carlos, yeah. Guerrero Garcia. That's my brother-in-law's name. But when I first glanced at my phone and I didn't see it carefully, I thought it was saying, Antonio Carlos Jobim has sent you a friend request on Facebook. And I was like, what? And I was like, oh, it's Alejandro, not Antonio exactly. Carlos Jobim. I thought I'd share that fun story with you. Thank you. That was One Note Samba, composed by the great Brazilian composer Antonio Carlos Jobim. It's kind of redundant, composed by the composer. I just realized as I was saying that sentence. Thank you so much for joining us. If you haven't already left a comment and say hello, please do so, because after this next and last tune, we're going to say hello to all of you. It's been so great having you all here. I've seen that a lot of people are watching tonight. And I did see some comments popping up. I couldn't tell who they were from, but we look forward to finding out who they're from. So once again, just to recap, if you've been enjoying the music tonight, please head on over to lauradubin.com after we play this last tune. There's a link right in the video here, and the link will take you right to the music/store page of my website. And there you can download our albums. We've got 7 albums that you can choose from. Album number 8 is on the way, so hang tight for that. We'll have an announcement about that very soon. If you scroll a little bit past the pictures of the album covers, you'll see where you can make a one-time donation. There are several suggested amounts that you can choose from, but you can also adjust the amount by changing the quantity if you would like to do that. And then the third and final option is you can become a monthly patron of Laura Dubin Jazz. If you scroll all the way to the bottom of that page, that's where you'll see that option. And there's a drop-down menu where you can click on the amount that you'd like to donate once per month. Then when you click the yellow button that says subscribe, you'll be redirected to a PayPal website. And that's where you can set up your automatic recurring credit card payment. So if you happen to use autopay for any of your bills, it pretty much works in the same way. You just set it up one time and then you don't have to think about it anymore. It'll just automatically go through once a month. And if you'd like to see us doing these videos as long as possible, that's a great way to show your ongoing support. PayPal stores your information securely. My website is also secure. However, if you want to make a donation but you prefer not to do it online, please send me a private message on Facebook and we can talk about another method. And of course, if you're not able to make a donation right now, that's okay. We are so grateful that you're here. We thank you so much for listening to our music and watching our video tonight. And especially a huge thank you to those of you who have been watching these every night. Your support has really meant so much to us and made us feel like what we're doing is important during this time.
Yes, you are the best.
Such a great experience for us.
Best audience. Thank you.
Truly,
thank you very
yes.
much.
Thank you, everyone, so much. So we look forward to saying hello to you after we play this last tune. And the last piece we're going to play tonight is called Black Nile, composed by the great saxophonist Wayne Shorter. Thank you. was Black Nile, composed by Wayne Shorter. And that is all the music for tonight, but we hope you'll join us at the same time tomorrow night, 8:30 p.m. We'll be doing these every night until the end of time, as far as we know at this point in our lives. Please stick around if you'd like to chat with us. I'm going to read through all the comments here and say hello to everybody. And don't forget to tune in tomorrow morning, bright and early, 8:40 a.m. We're going to be on Good Day Rochester on Fox Rochester. I believe it's channel 31 on our TV.
31, yeah.
I'm not sure if that's the channel for everybody. We don't have cable, so if you have cable, it might be a different channel for you, but it's definitely Fox Rochester. So I saw a lot of comments pop up, so I'd love to see who's watching. And just so you're aware, and most of you already know this if you've been watching every night, but if you're new, I try to read all the comments. Sometimes, for whatever reason, Facebook has kind of a weird algorithm, and for some reason, they don't all show up when I look at them at the end of the video. Most of them seem to show up most of the time, but sometimes there are a couple that just don't appear for some reason. I think it's because the video is still live. However, if I miss your comment, I am going to read through them again after we finish playing, and then they definitely all show up. And if there are any comments that I missed, I will reply to them online, just to let you know, so that nobody gets offended. If I miss your comment, it's actually not because I just ignored it. It's actually just because I didn't see it. Thanks, Facebook. Facebook really needs to correct that issue. If Mark Zuckerberg is watching right now, please take that to heart. Ooh, a lot of comments saying there's a lot of people still watching. Yay, hello everyone. Thank you so much for being with us. This is like the next best thing to hanging out with each other in real life. Hey Dad, thank you so much for watching. He said,
Dan, thank you.
He enjoyed tonight's concert, especially Red Clay. I haven't heard that in a while.
Yeah,
isn't that such a great tune? It's so much fun to play. And for me, like as a pianist, my favorite part of that tune is all the sus chords. Mm-hmm. That mean, for non-musicians out there, that means a suspended chord, which means
the fourth.
Yeah. So instead of a basic chord like that, 1, 3, 5, it's got the fourth note that means like a suspended fourth. But in jazz, usually it sounds more kind of like this. Like, oh, what's the chord I just played? That's an example of a sus chord in jazz, and this tune is just like chock full of them, and it's one of my favorite kinds of chords.
Yeah, thank you, Jan. Yeah. Thank you.
Hey, Cindy.
I love that.
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to talk over you. Sorry. Cindy and Dave did a watch party again. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Cindy and Dave Boyer. Thank you so much for watching. It's so great to have you both here. I'm looking at these backwards a little bit. Let's see. Betsy, great to have you here again.
Thank you, Betsy.
She says, I told Maggie that you taught piano music, and she said, tell her I'm trying to learn. I wish she could teach me. Oh, that's so sweet. Actually, a little public service announcement. I'm glad you brought this up, Betsy. I am actually teaching online piano lessons right now. I teach at a beautiful studio in Pittsburgh called Musically Fit, which is owned by a wonderful woman named Kim Schifino, who's the main piano teacher there. But of course, now we're not teaching at the studio. We're actually just doing remote lessons. So I've been teaching through FaceTime, Skype, and Zoom, whatever the students have. And it's actually been going really well. So Betsy, if your granddaughter's interested, or if anybody else out there is interested, I'd be happy to talk with you about that. I can do a free 15-minute demo lesson. You can try it out and see if you like it. No obligation, but it'd be great to try if you're interested. So if anybody wants to do that, you can leave a comment here, or you can just send me a message, or if you just leave a comment saying that you're interested, then I can reach out to you from there. So thank you so much, Betsy. That's so great. Hey, Donna, thanks for watching again.
Donna, thank you. April
is Jazz Appreciation Month. Yes, it is. And actually, you can't see it in the camera, but we've got a whole bunch of Jazz Appreciation Month
posters
on our wall. Yeah. I collect them every year. Well, sometimes I don't get them in time because they only make a limited number of those posters every year. But I've got three here, and then we've got a couple more that I haven't hung up yet.
Yeah.
But yes, it's Jazz Appreciation Month. It's so awesome. Yeah.
It's Mary Lou Williams, right?
So you can't see. I'll have to take a picture and put it in the
comments. We should take a picture and then show it to...
We got Mary Lou Williams on the wall.
John Coltrane, probably.
Yeah, that's Coltrane. And then in the
middle...
Mingus? Yeah, it looks like... I think it's Charles Mingus, Benny Goodman, Charlie Parker, beautiful. John Coltrane, somebody, like, some of them, there's like some instruments, like the end of a trombone with a hand, but no, yeah, no face.
Yeah, beautiful art.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah.
So painting. Thank you. I'm glad that you know that, Donna. And actually, thank you, I think Donna. The last day of April, April 30th, is like World Jazz Appreciation Day. So we'll do a fun program for that night. Hey, Linda, thank you so much for watching.
Hey, she Linda, says, thank you.
One Note Samba was wonderful. Oh, hey, thank you.
Thank you.
She says, new music every night. How do you do it? It's good, a good challenge for us to not repeat tunes. We probably will at some point, but right now we're challenging ourselves to see how long we can go without doing it. Because yeah. There's so much great music, and a lot of these tunes have been in our repertoire for a long time, but we haven't played all of them, you know, at our live performances recently because... as those of you who come to our live performances know, we try to do a lot of new music regularly, especially because we have a lot of wonderful friends who come to see our performances a lot. And so especially for that reason, we always try to kind of switch our programming. So there are a lot of pieces that we played maybe like for a period of time, maybe a year or two ago, and now we're kind of playing them again. So it's really fun. It's been
like
great for us
because we
that.
Come back a little bit with tunes that we never play, well, since...
Recently, yeah.
Yeah, recently.
Yeah, and it feels different coming back to them years later. And sometimes for me, especially for my own, like, compositions that I wrote, for example, like, our first album, when we were recording that album, it's all original music that I wrote, and we were practicing that music so much, you know, to get ready for the recording, and we're so happy with how it turned out. You know, after that project ended, we were ready to move on and do another project, and so I kind of took a break from... playing those particular compositions of mine for a while, but then like a year or two later we would come back to them and they felt really fresh, so that's kind of nice.
Yeah,
it's a great
nice
feeling.
Always you come back with something new,
yeah,
in some way
you're kind
you
of
know?
Like a new person, and you're bringing your new life experiences to the table,
exactly.
I guess, or the instrument.
Yes, thank you Linda.
Thank you so much, Linda. Siobhan! Hi, Siobhan! Thank you so much for watching.
Thank you, Siobhan.
Achilles and I, that's her, my sister's dog, who I love, Achilles and I are very fond of the João Gilberto version. Oh my gosh, me too. Mm-hmm. It's actually one of like my favorite albums. Is it Gilberto or Gilberto? I might
Gilberto,
not.
I Gilberto.
Yeah, especially the albums he did with Stan Getz. They're some of my favorite mm-hmm. albums, and it's just such beautiful music. I was actually listening to that album when I was cooking a few days ago. It was very, very nice and made me feel kind of relaxed while I was chopping vegetables and stuff.
Yeah, so much beautiful music.
Alejandro, your brother, says, my God, you made me laugh a lot. I'm glad. It was so funny when I literally thought I was getting a Facebook friend request from Antonio Carlos Jobim, because my dear brother-in-law, Alejandro Jr., just got Facebook for the first time. Otherwise, we would have been Facebook friends since like a long time ago. But he actually just got on Facebook this week. So yeah, I was excited to get a friend request from him. I was like, wow, he's on Facebook now.
I appreciate that because he just got it for being in touch with us watching these videos.
Yeah, so we appreciate
you,
that
you
so
very much.
Much muchas gracias.
Thank you, my brother, my little brother.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Chaparrito.
Yay.
And Alejandro Sr. is also watching. Hola.
Thank you. Gracias, Ale.
Hola, Ma and Deanna. Hola, Ma. I'm sure everybody's watching. Thank you so much.
Oh, I love my family. Thank
you.
Yeah.
Chris Nose. Hi, Chris. Did I say your name correctly? If you're still watching, I pronounce it Nose. But if your last name is pronounced differently, please let me know if I said it wrong. Thank you so much for being here. So Chris is somebody who saw our news segment a few nights ago, and they've been watching every night since then. So we're so delighted that
you're
here.
Chris.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
And we're so excited to be on the news again this week. So it was really great doing it the other day. Yeah. And the other day it was especially great because the newscast was at 6 p.m., which was just a little bit before we started playing. So I think that helped a lot of people come over here. Mm-hmm. So hopefully tomorrow, if people watch early in the morning, they'll still remember to tune in like 12 hours later. Actually, yeah, it is going to be almost 12 hours later because tomorrow we're going to be on at 8:40 a.m. And then we start these at 8:30 p.m.
Yeah, no,
I'll mention that in the interview that it's 12 hours from now.
It's a great promotion. Thank you.
Yeah.
What is the name? Do you remember the name of...
Good Day Rochester?
Yeah.
The one that we're doing tomorrow, yes. Or the one that we did the other day?
No, tomorrow.
Oh, the name of the program is called Good Day Rochester.
No, but the people who's going to do the interview.
Oh, you know, the guy I was emailing is the executive producer of the show, exactly. Named Mike.
I remember him because we played there for the jazz festival, right?
Yeah. So I'm not sure if he'll be conducting the interview. I think he might be. I guess we'll find out. He's the person that I've been in contact with. Last year, we went and performed on the show live a couple days before our jazz festival appearance. And apparently they are the official channel of the Rochester Jazz Fest. So a lot of the artists who were coming to Rochester from other places came on that show, Good Day Rochester, a few days before the jazz fest or during the festival. I think we were the first ones, though. We kicked off the Jazz Festival week on a Monday, so that was pretty exciting. So we're looking forward to being back again tomorrow, even though it will just be remotely. We'll be doing an interview through Skype. They'll be showing our video of these concerts as well. So we hope that you'll tune in. And let's see here. I'm going to go over to my other Facebook page. If you're watching this on my regular, my personal Facebook page, oh, there's one comment here. Yay.
What?
Oh, perfect. It's Cindy again. Hi, Cindy. Again, thank you so much. Cindy is mentioning again that she had a watch party tonight. Thank you. And we noticed a lot of people were watching, so I'm sure that was thanks to you,
Dave.
Thank you,
Cindy. Thank you. Thank you for sharing with your friends.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You were just about to say something. Sorry. What were you going to say?
Because your Facebook page is Lena Dubin, pianist,
that's what
and
I was
composer.
Gonna say. Yeah. So my personal Facebook page is the one that's just my name. And if you're watching this video on that page, please head on over to my Facebook music page, Laura Dubin Jazz, and give that page a like, because then you'll be notified every time we do a live video, anytime we post any other kind of music-related content. You'll just be more in the know. We do these concerts every night at 8:30, so you could just like check back every night at 8:30. But if for any particular reason we need to move the time, I always post an update around the time, around 8:30, if that happens. And if you'd like the page, then you'll just receive a notification when that happens. And just in general, you'll be alert for any news that we might share. You can also sign up for my mailing list. If you haven't joined my mailing list yet, that's actually the first place where I always make big announcements. And you can either just send me a message here on Facebook and just let me know what your email address is. Or you can go to my website, just the homepage of my website, scroll down a little bit, and you'll see an email list sign up form. You'll just type your email address there and click on the button that says submit or something. And I'll receive that notification immediately, and then I can just add you to my list from there. But we hope you'll consider signing up for that, because again, that's the first place where I always make big announcements when we have them.
Yeah.
And then later on, I'll typically post them here on Facebook as well. So thank you everyone for watching. So great to have you all here. We will see you again at the same time tomorrow night. Bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.